And now, I'd like to play one of my very favorite songs for you.
Hey, no one but Omertas are allowed to carry guns into Gamora. Check your weapons with me. You'll get these back on your way out.
Hello and welcome to Gamora. What can I help you with today?
Feel free to head to our club, Brimstone, or you can see our gorgeous courtyard out behind the casino. I knew someone would call in that mark soon. What do you want to know? All I can tell you is to find Cuccino. He's the lowest level lieutenant you're going to be able to talk to. Some of the girls say he's been involved in some shady business the family wouldn't really like. Ask him about it. Sorry, we don't have any hotel rooms available right now, but feel free to gamble or help yourself to our other services. I sure do, but loose lips sink ships. All right, you look pretty trustworthy. Not much of a rumor, but I hear the Tops is always looking for new talent. Lord knows they've needed it for a long time. I've heard some pretty shady rumors about the Ultralux. I'm not sure what the deal is, but although they try to put on airs, that place is just plain creepy. Maybe it's the masks. It's hard to believe that not too long ago, most of the families on the Strip were little more than warring tribes. The Omertas even had a big war with the Khans once upon a time. I hear you've actually been inside Lucky 38. You're the first person who's been in there in as long as anybody can remember. Sorry, that's all the news worth talking about. All I have, at least. Bye.
I hear you've been asking questions about me, dickweed. What the fuck do you want? Business? What the fuck do you mean, business? You looking to get yourself burned? Now you start talking real clear, and I mean fucking crystal clear, because I'm about to lose my patience. I don't give half a dick what you heard. Now get the fuck out of my face before I burn your sorry ass.
Till the moment we met, I had no one to cling to be just everything to be my own true love.
Town of our three, who rode a stranger one fine day. Hardly spoke to folks around him, didn't have too much to say. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. The stranger there among them had a big iron on his hip, big iron on his hip. It was early in the morning when he rode into the town. He came riding from the south side, slowly looking all around. He's an outlaw, loose and running, came a whisper from each lips. And he's here to do some business with a big iron on his hip, big iron on his hip.
In this town, you again? What the fuck do you want? Where the fuck did you get that? Okay, listen, buddy. That's some dangerous shit you got there. That book can get me killed if the wrong people see it. Let's talk. What do you want? What can I do for you?
And the notches on his pistol numbered 1 in 19 more. 1 in 19 more.
Now the stranger's I can't stop you, but that's gonna mean my death. I can make it with you a while to give it to me, though. Plus, if you go to the bosses, I can't help you stop what they've been doing.
He came here to take an outlaw back alive or maybe dead. And he said it didn't matter, he was after Texas Red.
Okay, you got me by the balls. Here's a couple hundred caps. Maybe that'll buy you friendship.
Wasn't long before the story was relayed.
I can pay you for it, of course. I also have some information about the family's business that you might find interesting. Between you and I, we can break up what they're planning, maybe save some lives. Mine included, of course.
20 men had made a slip. 21 would be the ranger with the big iron on his hip.
Oh, here's some caps. Now give me the journal. Right, there we go. So let me tell you what I know about the family's business. The bosses, Big Sal and Nero, have been working for a while on this. They're arming themselves like an army, using this new guy, Troik. They also brought in a specialist named Clandon. At least that's what they introduced him as. I got no fucking idea. They let him have the run of the place, though. Seems like a nice guy, but he makes me nervous. He's a little arrogant, but he's too nice. Too open. I've never seen him fucking or gambling. Everyone has a vice, but this guy seems like the Pope.
And the swiftness of
okay, toss him at me. He's a skittish little fucker. Spends half the day pumping his body full of chems and the other half pumping hookers with his willy. He has some kind of connections, so he's able to smuggle huge shipments of weapons into the strip. The boss has got him by the short hairs. We covered up a hooker he killed while flying on some psycho, so he gets his guns in exchange for not ratting. Okay, you can find me here or upstairs in my room. I'll let the muscle know you're a friend of mine. That should let you get around a little easier. Hey, what can I do for you? All right, let's have him. No, just that it involves guns and muscle. Also that it's big. Very big. Only Nero and Big Saul know everything, and they ain't telling. Okay, you can find me here or upstairs in my room.
It's me again, Mr. New Vegas, reminding you that you're nobody till somebody loves you. And that somebody is me. I love you. We've got some news for you coming right up.
Who are you? I didn't do anything. Leave me alone. I don't see how that's your business. I'm just a guest here, having a little fun. Cacino? Cacino what? Are you kidding me? You must be trying to get me killed. Yeah? Well, fuck that. The bosses have my number, and I'm a company man while they got the goods on me. Oh, man. I don't even like to think about it. All that goddamn blood. It was just in the hotel like any other night. I took some Kims with the girl I was with, but I never black out. I did this time, though. Next thing I knew, I woke up, she was lying next to me, stabbed dead. There was a knife next to the bed, and I was covered in her blood. I keep a little switchblade tucked away with me. You never know when you might find some trouble. All right, have at it. That night, mostly buff out, I like to cut it with a little bit of jet and wash it down with some whiskey. That was my standard Saturday night. What? Yeah, you're right. I wonder what was up with that. What do you want to talk about? Goodbye. You again. Make it quick. Oh. When I saw the body, I started screaming. In a few seconds, some of their soldiers were in there cleaning up the room. They offered to keep silent about what happened if I agreed to help them get their hands on large quantities of guns at deep discounts. You'd do that for me? I'm not sure what can be done, but you'd be doing me a solid if you would. I've been talking to Big Saul mostly.
Whoa, the great Caesar is dead. The management doesn't seem too happy.
Hey, nice to meet you. Do you need help with something? A little bit of this and a little bit of that. I'm a close friend of some of the family around here. I do some independent contracting around the casino, and they set me up at this great room. Cachino. Yeah, I've heard the name. Not sure why he'd send you to me. Is he helping out with room service or something?
When this next song goes out from me.
Making some waves around here.
Hey, you're Cachino's friend. You got business with me? Ah, Trike. What's he want? Some more jet? A fresh batch of girls? Maybe a guy or two this time. What, that he's a murdering jet head? Not a new story around here. Really? That was his idea? All right, he can go. Hopefully he finds us some good deals out there. We run a hotel. What do you think our business is? All right, come back anytime.
You again. Make it quick. Holy shit. Really? Okay, I'll help you. But I'm getting the hell out of here first chance I get. They're keeping them in a little utility section down off the basement. I don't know what they're arming themselves for, but I know it isn't for the good of mankind. I'm pretty proud of myself. It's a stroke of genius if I could be so modest.
The whole arrangement starts with an old buddy of mine in the Republic. He's responsible for packing and shipping supplies to the NCR on the Strip. He marks some containers as food and medical and packs them with guns and other shit. From there, it took just a couple of greased palms to get someone to let me cherry pick a container or two out of every shipment. Easy as pie. Okay, try and be fast about it. As a little pet project, I've been making some thermite. Thermite burns as hot as the devil's asshole and can melt through just about anything. I've been keeping it so if the family betrays me, I can hopefully do some damage before I end up dead or in jail. Okay, here's the thermite and a key to the room where the guns are stored. Place the thermite on the crates in the room. I rig the light switch outside the room to kick off a spark big enough to hold the thermite. That should turn that shit into molten slag. As soon as we're done talking, I'm gonna make myself like a ghost. I don't want to be anywhere near here when the bosses find out. Thermite is a mix of rust and aluminum dust. If you add a little heat, a massive amount of heat is spit out. It gives off enough heat to melt through just about anything. It should make short work of the weapons. All right, let's. Later.
Hey, what can I do for you?
Whoa, you managed to pull that off? Solid work. That ought to gum up the boss's plans.
Now we cut off the head of the serpent. Big Saul and Nero have to die.
As long as they're alive, they can start up their plans again. All you've managed to do is stall them. I guarantee you they have contingencies. They're a little bit upset about what's been done to muck up their plans. They tasked me to find out who's responsible. There isn't gonna be another chance to get both of them together in the same room. I'll slip you a gun, and we can take them out. When they're gone, I'm gonna run this joint. Don't worry, I'll take care of this place. Hurry and get ready. I'll give you a gun when you get to the room.
I should have bet we'd kill the fiend's leader.
Hey, here's that gun I promised you. I suggest using it while they are talking.
Let's have some words. Take a seat on the couch so we can get to talk.
Howard. Got kicked out of Trolex the other day. Man, that place gives me the fucking freaks. Hey, thanks for all the hard work back there. I'm gonna run a tight ship here, don't you worry. Of course. After all you did for me, here are some chips for you. Play. Have some fun.
Bye.
Thank you.